Welcome back, Classic Gamers, and thanks for viewing Jay the Classic Gamer's game review of the 1985 classic game, Golf, by Nintendo for the Nintendo Entertainment System. I play real golf, and I love golf video games, and this is one of my all-time favorites. Nintendo's golf game was released as part of the Nintendo Sports series, and set the bar pretty high for future golf games, whether it was the PGA Tour series or the Mario Golf series. They used some aspects of this game. The object of the game is to get your ball in the hole in the fewest amount of strokes and shoot for the lowest score possible. This game has one 18-hole golf course with a par of 72. There are only two penalties in this game. If you hit the ball out of bounds, you take a one-stroke penalty and have to re-hit the ball. If you hit the ball in the water hazard, you take a one-stroke penalty, but you get a drop to the nearest point of relief. This is a one or two player game. If you play a friend in stroke play, the winner is determined by who shoots the lowest score. If you play them in match play, the winner is determined by who wins the most holes. When you start the game, you will notice the box in the upper left. This shows you what hole you're on, the total yards to the hole, the par of the hole, wind direction, the number of shots you have taken in this hole, and your score. The controls are very simple. The left and right on the control pad aims your shot. The up and down on the control pad changes your clubs. Once you have aimed for the fairway or green and selected a club, press the A button once to start your swing. Hit it a second time for your power and hit it a third time for your accuracy. When you're putting, it's a little different. Press the A button once to start your swing and once more for your power. What I love about this game is that they don't tell you how far your clubs go, or how far you are from the hole after your first shot, and that you can't aim right at the flag all the time, making this game much more challenging than newer golf games. I only have a few complaints about this game. The first complaint is that there is no rough lies in this game. You always hit from a fairway, a bunker, or the green. The second complaint is that the trees are considered out of bounds, even if your ball is barely in them. The third complaint is sometimes when you're hitting out of a bunker and you hit a good shot using the sand wedge, it only goes a few feet. The last complaint is the complete absence of music, and it only has a few sound effects that are really bad. Here's what they should have done. Now that would have been awesome. Since you can't aim exactly where you want to in this game, you have to learn the technique called shaping the ball. If you stop the arrow past the straight meter, your ball will draw. It moves from the right to left. If you stop the arrow before the straight meter, your ball will slice. It moves from left to right. Use this technique to get your ball closer to the hole. The chipping in this game can be very difficult, so I recommend that if you're close to the green, use your putter, not your sand wedge. Most people find putting the most difficult part in this game, so here's a few tips. When reading the greens, the arrows show you which way the green breaks. The more arrows there are on the green, the more it breaks. The smaller amount of arrows there are on the green means it's going to break less. So make sure you make the proper adjustments according on how many arrows there are on the green. If you have a tap-in putt, just hit the A button twice really fast. If you're just outside of a tap-in putt, play the break and don't let the power meter go past Mario's back foot. When facing an uphill putt, make sure you hit the ball a little harder. When going downhill, make sure you hit the ball a little softer. Okay, now here's a quick list of what clubs to use on each hole. I caution you, some of these will vary depending on how hard you hit the ball and your wind, so make your adjustments accordingly. If you use these tips wisely, you'll be erasing shots from your game immediately. After 5 rounds of playing this game for this review, I went from a +6 in my first game to a -12 in my 5th round. All you need is just a little practice and you'll be playing like the pros in no time. So this concludes my video game review of Golf. I have to score this game a solid 8 out of 10. I would have given it a 10 if they added the Super Mario Bros. Music like I suggested. But it's a fun, challenging, classic game, and a must-have for any true classic golf gamer.